I want it all before I'm gone.
For sure, I thought it was fine, but Bill.
Yeah, buddy.
Lot of action.
Okay, good morning, everybody. Let's start off with a freaking weird dream alert. My God, what the hell? Last night was a weird one. We didn't get that good of sleep. I had this like CO2 thing that was going beep, beep, you beep four times. And I'm like, oh, what the hell is it? And then it beep again. And it was like tapping all night. Amanda helped out and she went and, put it in another room. I just freaking wanted to throw it off the roof. Anyway, the weird dream alert. Okay, this is nuts. I'm playing poker in this dream, right? And somebody, I have my phone out. Someone looks at it and they put some sort of ray thing on it. I don't know what the hell, and I'm like, oh, okay. And then I look and it's like frozen. My phone is frozen, can't get in. And for some reason it's causing me a lot of anxiety or pain or something, whatever. So I'm playing in this poker game and I'm losing. And all of a sudden, cause it's a dream, weird things happen. All of a sudden this poker game is now in North Korea. So I'm playing poker in North Korea and they won't let me leave. When I win a pot, I get moved to another table. And then like I'm playing with everyone cheating me. Like they're all cheating and I try to go and they won't let me and they're all laughing at me and stuff like that. And so then all of a sudden, like I'm like in tears almost. I don't know where to go, what to do. And I see Phil Ivey over there with a freaking bag of popcorn laughing at me. Phil Ivey's laughing at me with a bag of popcorn. And then I start talking to him and like, then all of a sudden his buddy Dennis Rodman shows up because it's North Korea. And I'm like, dude, they won't let me leave. And Phil just laughs. He's like, no, you just gotta fight through it. I'm like, fight through? How am I supposed to fight through it? These guys, like, they won't let me win. They won't let me leave. They won't let me do anything. Like, it's so weird. And they're all giggling and laughing, like an example of a hand. It's like a, whatever, queen nine, seven flop or something like that. Guy bets 2K in this dream. The other guy gets four, raises to 4K. I call the 4K. That guy makes it 6K. This is a no limit. The other guy makes it 10K. I'm like, ah, I see, I get it. Yeah. I'm getting, and they go, oh, like, it was so unbelievable. What a brutal dream. My God. And then, like, I don't know, Amanda was, she'd never done this before, but she said babe twice. I think she was talking in her sleep. Cool. I don't know. So weird dream alert, not the best sleep, but we got to get it together here for day two. We've got not a big stack, but we've got 12 big bets in limit, which is, it's still workable. But obviously we didn't have a good day one. Looking forward for some better run good on day two. All right, so we're a little early, 1:15 in the trailer. Figured I'd put out a tweet, maybe Pierre will talk a little bit about the Poker Hall of Fame, which is a pretty cool thing. I'm a purist, okay? It frustrates me a little bit, when a lot of people in the media or whatever, they basically have completely gone off the rails in terms of like, there's the criteria, and then there's what they decide to vote based on. And it has nothing to do with the criteria, like for the vast majority of times. They use it as a guideline rather than actual, use the criteria. Like the criteria is there for a reason. You should vote based on that. And for me, I look at the skill of a player, his accomplishments, and whether he stood the test of time as being super important, playing against high stakes, things like that. And that just kind of rules out a couple players, and it also makes a better case for some. And the other thing I don't care about, like first Chris Ferguson's perfect example. He obviously has a scandal associated with him, and, I didn't have a lot of respect. I don't have a lot of respect for how he handled that and then the apology later. Having said that, does that have anything to do with his skills at the table? I'm not voting for him. I'm not going to give him my vote simply because I don't think he's as good as a poker player as some of the others, and they've played higher stakes and cash games, and I'm always going to give a lot of credence to that. So I'm not voting for him, but I think he should be eligible, and he certainly qualifies as a nominee, and it shouldn't be excluded because of like business stuff that happened outside of the game. That's my opinion. Howard Letter are the same. He should be allowed to be nominated. He won't, because he wasn't that good of a player either. So the person that I look at and I think to myself, okay, if of that 10, if you're being honest, if you're really being honest and you say to yourself, who's the biggest killer there that you not want to play poker with? Who's the guy that still continually, after years and years, plays the highest stakes cash games in Bobby's room and is a crusher and plays all the games? And that's David Oppenheim. I mean, David Oppenheim has been doing this for a long time, from the Larry Flint game to Bobby's room, whatever. He's not a tournament guy, but that's not what this is about. It doesn't say anything about like specific tournament results. It's just about, for me, who's most respected by his peers. Now ask around people who play all the games. Which one of those players do they not want at their table to play heads up with or shorthanded if they're playing high-stakes mixed games or something like that. Oppenheim's going to be the one. It's a clear-cut favorite as far as I'm concerned. So I'm likely to give Oppenheim half my votes, and then the other half still up for grabs. But it won't be based off of popularity. It won't be based off of... Now, there's a builder category. There's no builders in it this year, although you could argue Moneymaker is one. You know, because he's not going to get in based on his accomplishments, because after he won the main event, he had a couple finishes. But, you know, he hasn't exactly competed at the highest level for quite some time. So, you know, my take, and this was my idea. Jeff Platt was talking about, this is my idea. Every 3 years, they should have a separate induction for people in the builder category. Make nominees specifically for builders, okay? And then you put one in every 3 years, and then leave the other side alone, which has nothing to do with building. It doesn't matter if you were a jerk, the biggest jerk of all time. If you were a killer at the table, that's what I'm voting on. It's not about popularity or personality. What other Hall of Fame does that, right? In baseball, they don't go, oh, you know, he only hit 210, and you know, but he was a nice guy and did a lot for the community. It's got nothing to do with the vote. What he's done, nothing, nothing. It's got nothing. It's a builder category thing. If you vote him in as a builder, cool. But if you're voting as a player, vote based as a player. And the player that goes in, as far as I'm concerned, that's a head and above, head and shoulders above the rest, is David Oppenheim.
About to leave, already packing. Come with me. I'm not really asking.
Early 50K table. That's a Jesse Martin sighting. Congratulations to this gentleman. Just had a baby and then decided to come play one tournament and win it. 25K PLO. And then we got the brown dog, who was just bragging about not cheating on his wife. Yet, where's the ring?
I'm a loyal dog.
He's a loyal dog. Never cheated. You and Phil Hellmuth.
True.
He's got less chips than me. He's got less chips than me. Julia Martini. And there's a horsey. Just about to get started here. Day two of the 50K. Well, the effort was short-lived today. Incredibly frustrating to lose. I mean, I still had, like I said, a decent amount of chips. We started with stud eight, which is great. First hand, I had deuce, four, five, six, and a pair of fours. Catch a king and a queen. Brick that. And then a triple draw hand. Lost that to Steve Chigwick. Couldn't beat a nine with two draws to go. And then, what else? Oh my God. It was just like when it rains, it pours. The very last hand of PLO, I had ace, queen, 10, nine. I only had, what did I have? 20K left. I was up against aces, flopped a straight draw, missed that. So incredibly tilting. That's probably outside of the main event. Oh, I don't know. They're pretty close. Main event, maybe a little bit more. The most tilting event to bust from, especially the way that this one went down. I literally was like, never had a chance. I just did not, just didn't want, you have to win hands once in a while. I just didn't win any hands in that one. Incredibly frustrating. I was a limit hold'em hand too. I was in there with 10-8 of spades against ace queen. Flop was 10-6-6. Turns that queen. So, and yeah, so that's it, man. We're gonna have to look at the schedule right now and regroup and try to win a bracelet in some other event.
To a place where we don't know.
All right, people, the show must go on. Bust the 50K, took a little time to recollect, and it's on to the next one. We're doing the $600, going from the 50K to the $600 deep stack thingamajigger. 40 minute levels today with a single reentry. So for you high stakes package people, you're 0-3. Not a good situation, but we gave it our all. And for you low stakers right now, we're gonna get in there and then we're gonna grind this $600 deep stack thingamajiggy. All right, I'm puzzled. We just got our seat assignment and it says late registration in El Burro. What the hell is El Burro? I didn't know there was an El Burro here. I've never heard of the El Burro room. It's so bizarre, I don't know. I'll walk around here until I find it. What's up, gents? What the hell, El Burro? Maybe it's the burrito stand area. I don't know. Cheap hair. So let's see if maybe that's the spot we're supposed to go. El Burro. There's people in line. Yikes. All right, I'm being told El Burro is in a place I've never even knew they had poker. I think it's in like a stock room or something. I don't know. El Burro, they just go, keep walking, other hallway. I have no idea where I'm going. This is ridiculous.
About to see the world in action. We can be life with no distractions. We'll get away. This is what we waited for.
Good, buddy. Still walking. Still walking. This feels like this is quite a little adventure. This is part of the Rio that I don't ever see. I think I'm going the right way. And this is going to sound hashtag
rich people problems or whatever you want to call it, but like, this is probably not all that convenient for trailer brakes. Oh, I did say it. Yeah, I know what you're going to say.
It's okay.
I'm just saying. This is quite far.
I think we may be approaching El Burro. Is this El Burro? El Burro. El Burro. El Burro, late.
Where do I go? Okay.
El Burro. We made it. This is where we are. Okay. This is comfy, convenient. All the people are here. Hi. What's up, y'all? Okay, 600 deep stacks. Let's do this.
You're over.
You guys knew where the burro was?
I assume it's next to the Mexican place.
I thought this was the burro. That's exactly right. Yeah. Thanks. Looks like Norm MacDonald just lost the pie. Hey, I find you in El Burro. This is where you hang out, huh? All right, a little deep stack. What's up, people? Hey! I'm gonna sit here, is that okay?
I would love it!
Alright. You're gonna deep. Hey, what's up? Last time I saw you was a wedding.
No, last time you saw me, you were running down the hall.
Yeah. Look at this, we got a fun table. Everybody's all in. In El Burro. Yo estoy en El Burro ahora.
Okay, about 30 minutes into my stay here in El Burro, the smoke is getting to me. The low ceilings are hurting. My friend here on the left forgot her asthma thingy. Right, and she's coughing it up. Quite a different experience. Not so sure I'm a fan right now. You like playing in here?
Huh?
You like playing in here?
No.
No, okay, fair.
I'm not the smoker.
You're not a smoker, yeah.
Break us free from El Burro!
All right, I'm going to describe my Burro experience as less than optimal. I mean, if the time, how long it takes to get back to trailer so we're not late. I left off some chips on the hand right before the dinner I had. What's up? I had like 32K. And I turned I flopped the gutter, turned a flush draw, bluffed the river. The guy called the top pair. So we got 16,000. Good news with this one is there is a re-entry. And if we do re-enter, we are praying that, you know, we don't go back to the burro. I don't ever want to go back to the burro, man. It's dangerous out there, bro. You don't want to hang in the burro. Okay, we busted in the burro. In El Burro. With sixes against kings. And we are going to go back to the main area. Ooh, echoes over here. And re-enter. And hopefully do not draw El Burro again. We want no El Burro. No El Burro, please. What do we got? What does that say? Pavilion! Yeah! Dodged it.
Right here is the late reg table. Looks like we have a line. You know how patient I am? I'm the most patient person ever. This one's not too bad, right? That's not so bad. I can fade that. That's alright.
Somehow. Oh, hi. So, I gotta be honest. The burro, I had an energy about me. It was fatigue and blah, blah, blah. Come into this room with high ceilings and no smoke. I feel so much better. I'm actually going to give it a good go now because it was tough out there. It's tough to find a spot where you want to fold because you're like double or go, you know? But not like I could, you know, I had sixes. What are you going to do? What are you going to do? Sixes. I have pocket sixes. You know what I'm saying? I had kings. Yeah, I mean, you know. Small blind over here. He got that. Big blind over here. I got that. Oh, taking a picture, that's awesome. Good job, man. Good job. What are you gonna do? Queens against aces. On to the next one, as they say. Good luck. Good luck, Lithuania. I played one hand, queens against aces.
In the $600 term, it's good for that to happen.
You know? Yeah, right? I'm done living
life with the lights out, die with my own doubt. All right, here we are in the PLO 8, and this gentleman right here is true to form. Show me this tattoo for a second. Life is a gamble. And he is a gambolero. It is confirmed. Yeah, he's playing pots.
Just a few.
Here we go. He's in there.
Just like 94%.
He's looking at his cards occasionally whenever he feels like it. He's having fun though, you can tell, right? That's what it's all about. Have a good time. Make some wheels. Okay, so we're gonna try to end this day the right way. We're gonna try to finish strong here. 2 more hours left in this $1,500 pot limit Omaha 8. Needless to say, but I'll say it anyway, I'm quite good at this game. It's just true. Probably the chip leader, I think that's what it said on the site, but who knows, others could have more, it doesn't matter. Got 100K, start with 25. Made some big high hands. One of the differences between this game in terms of flow. I play a lot of limit Omaha 8 in my life, but you make some adjustments where high hands you wouldn't normally play in Omaha 8 limit, I'm gonna play here. And position also is even more important. In addition to that, typically with high hands, play flops slower when there's low possibility, and then it turns very aggressive. So you don't want to get it all on a flop with two lows when you have a high hand. I'm going to wait till the turn, then put maximum pressure on them. So a couple strategy adjustments. We know what we're doing. You know, but a hand like, for example, King, King, 10, 4. We wouldn't play that cheese in Omaha 8 limit. But on the button against the raise and freaking, or even not, even just like a limp. It's like, okay, let's flop it to a set of kings and get these guys going bonkers. And we get in on the turn, not the flop, as I said, turn when they're just drawn to a low or maybe something silly. But we can pot it and put ourselves in good situations. So 2 more hours, finishing strong, hectic day. The team, man, ooh, the 25K team is not looking so hot. We still got 3 left with Hastings, who is live. Eric Wasserson, come on, Wass, come on, bro. He's live as well as John Monet. Everybody else, busto. Wait, well, did you wash your hands over there? That's the question. That's the most important question.
I don't touch my...
Okay, more important question.
I washed before.
Okay, but that's smart.
You know a lot about a man who washes before.
I washed before the whole time. So let me ask you a question. How many chips you got in the 50K?
I'm not sure.
You don't know. But you're doing just fine?
I'm doing all right.
Okay, people need to know. It's their daily Ivy
everybody
update.
Everybody has it as opposed to. You're out, right?
Yeah, of course. The Phil Ivy line. That's Phil Ivy's line when he's in a game. It's so funny. He'll be like playing. He'll have like 4 chips in front of him, and the suckers have like all the chips. He'll look around Taylor and be like, well, everyone has what they're supposed to have. So him saying everyone has what they're supposed to have and me being out was a big, you know. Thanks, Phil. Mikey does for me.
This is what I do. This is my new job, man. Right.
Mikey taking pictures for the people.
Mikey. I just want you to know, now me and Daniel are on good terms. I'll be working for him.
Oh,
as
God.
As a camera person.
Oh, camera person, sure.
Thank you for Daniel.
Yeah, let's do it. Oh, there's a puppy. Say hi to the puppy. Hey, puppy. Hi, little guy. That's a cutie puppy. Oh, that's nice that you bring your puppy. Oh, she brought out the puppy. All right, we playing last hand of the night. We're going to bag up 77-2, average is about 63,000. Can't complain about that, you know. One of the things about the World Series of Poker and the grind is, like, it's very difficult, but you got to do this. You got to, like, separate what happened from what's going to happen or what you're doing now. Like, 50K was obviously unfortunate. You know, it was a tough one for me because it's my favorite event. But the show must go on. You know, the focus must be there, and there's another World Series event always around the corner. So whether it's a $600 buy-in, a $2 buy-in, or a $100,000 buy-in, you got to bring the best possible game that you can. And that's what we're going to keep on doing, keep on trucking all the way through the main event. So good opportunity here in Pot Limit Omaha 8 or better. Be back tomorrow.
Take my hand, we'll make it somehow. We can make